Teagan Batstone was only 8 when her mother placed a plastic bag over her mouth and nose, holding it there for up to 4 minutes, uninterrupted. Her mother, Lisa Batstone, made the decision to kill her daughter, a decision with forethought. That's according to BC Supreme Court Justice Catherine Murray. Today, she found Batstone guilty of second-degree murder, as Teagan's father watched from the gallery.
There's no victory, right? There's no happiness. Teagan remains dead today, as she will be tomorrow and every day, so we have our memories. But that there was some accountability, you know, for that act, and that there's protection for children from this monster going forward.
Neither Crown nor defense argued whether Batstone killed her daughter, but whether it was done with intent. Defense claimed she was intoxicated and suffering from mental disorders, adding she couldn't perceive the consequences of her actions. The judge said although she believes Batstone was dealing with certain disorders, the murder was not impulsive. Her actions, choosing a heavy plastic bag, holding it over her, failing to call paramedics, all constituted a plan. In 2012, Lisa Batstone tried to take her own life. During the proceedings, Justice Murray said that Batstone had a plan. She wanted to kill herself, but she didn't want to leave Teagan behind. As for her sentence, which comes at a later date, Gabe's putting his faith in the court.
She took 70 years, 7 decades of Teagan's life, right? In a truly just society, you know, she should probably serve 70 years in jail. You know, that's what she took from Teagan.
Earlier this morning, Gabe posted photos of his daughter online, a tribute to her memory.
And I just wanted a bit of Teagan's love and joy and to remember that and not to remember her last moments, not to remember having, you know, a plastic bag held over her head for 5 minutes, right? You know, that's not what I want to leave here with. I want to leave her with her smile when she danced.
A sentencing hearing is scheduled for June 12th. Joel Ballard, CBC News, New Westminster.